I recently had my first experience with a Neato robot vacuum, the top-of-the-line Neato D7. It was a good one, and ever since, I've been wondering what the other vacuums in the Neato lineup are like and how they compare. Enter the Neato D6 Bot Vac Connected. I'm Erin from TechGadgetsCanada.com, and I recently had a chance to test it out and see what it's like as well. An early heads up that if you end up liking this video and finding it helpful, to please hit that like button and give us a sub, because it does help us keep making more videos that I hope everyone out there can watch, enjoy, and learn from. The Neato D6 is an app-controlled automated vacuum robot. What makes the Neato D6 different? Compared to the D7, the Neato D6 has just two fewer features. The D6 is without zone cleaning, meaning you have less ability to specify certain high traffic areas for extra cleaning. It's also missing something called manual drive remote control, which lets you steer the robot for special attention or specific cleaning. Other than that, they are virtually identical. The D6 also costs about $100 less than the D7. When you compare it to the more basic Neato D4, the D6 is a significant upgrade for just $200 extra. It has extra brushes and several extra features, including the ability to have multiple floor plans and to find your robot if it gets lost under some furniture. Those are the differences in specs anyway, but I noticed a substantial difference in overall performance. I'll explain. Neato has what's called LaserSmart technology. It scans and maps your entire house, creating a floor plan for your robot to follow. It moves exactly how a smart robot should, in straight lines instead of in a random pattern. Lasers even let it clean in the dark. Using the companion Neato app, you can set schedules, command at-the-moment cleaning, or even find your lost robot. Neato BotVac D6 also lets you use multiple floor plans, and it stores up to 3 floor plans inside the app. You'll love this if you have a multi-story home, because you'll be able to use it all over.
The app will also allow you to create areas where you can stop your vacuum from going. Virtual no-go lines tell your robot where not to venture. If you've got a room full of clothes on the floor you'd like the robot to avoid, you can add a no-go line at the entrance to that room right inside the Neato app. Problem chair that bottoms out the D6, or pet dishes you don't want sloshed, you can draw a box around troublesome areas to keep them out of bounds. If you want to go old school, you can also lay a strip of the included magnetic rail, which will prevent the bot from going into certain areas. The robot is quite easy to set up. You'll unpack all of the components from the box. Everything's pretty well wrapped, and you'll see some components that may seem like a bit of a mystery.
Let's get to know your Neato D6. Inside the box, you'll get the vacuum, the very small and compact base station, a small and mysterious looking comb, which is actually for cleaning the filters, as well as some flat tape-like substance that's magnetic. That's your boundary marker. There's also a plug. Unlike the D7, which comes with 2 extra filters for the dustbin, you only get 1 that's installed in the D6.
Plug the base station into the wall and connect the metal on the rounded end of the robot to the base station. Next up, download the Neato app and it'll walk you through how to get the robot vacuum connected to your home's Wi-Fi. Essentially, you'll push and hold the power button on the device for about 10 seconds or until the blue Wi-Fi symbol lights up. From there, you'll go to your phone's Wi-Fi settings and find the new network created labeled Neato. The app will step you through the next part, but you'll essentially connect to your home's Wi-Fi network and the device should connect quickly as mine did. I was ready to go in less than 5 minutes.
Neato BotVac D6 has a large core or roller brush. Neato says it's 70% bigger than those on round robots, and in a side-by-side here with another one, you can see that's true. Neato says that helps it pick up way more than before. The edge brush, on the other hand, is smaller by comparison.
Let's dig in on some of the features of the Neato D6. Neato is compatible with both Google and Alexa, so you can easily control Neato robots from your phone, smartwatch, Amazon Echo device, Google Home, or through IFTTT. Neato robot has a D shape that is supposed to help it getting closer to walls and corners, and it's a shape other vacuums have since adopted as well.
The Neato D6 robot works on all types of floor and can easily move between carpet, wood, tile, and laminate. I have carpet, tile, rugs, and hardwood in my house, and the Neato was able to navigate all of it.
Using the Neato D6 is easy. You've got a few ways you can start it. You can push the button on the device and it'll head out and clean. Schedule your cleanings inside the app. You can choose dedicated days and times that it'll go out automatically on its own, which is super handy for a thorough sweep while you're at the office. Or you can ask your digital assistant to send the bot out for you. Neato recommends cleaning the dustbin after every use. In my review period, I wasn't getting any kind of notifications that it was full, so after a couple of cleans, it was really full. I double-checked my notifications and made sure they were set to persistent on my iPhone. It seems like Neato's dustbin alerts are more on a timer and not so much geared at actually measuring if the bin is full. The setting called Dustbin Reminder has a little slider bar that gives you a choice of setting a reminder to empty the bin about every 30 minutes or so, or up to every 150 minutes of runtime. So I reset it and waited. I did get a push notification while the app was open, but not while the app was minimized or the phone was turned off or in standby mode. Okay, time to get to it. How well does the Neato D6 clean? Well, like the D7, it hugs edges really, really well. I found the robot to be very deliberate when it cleaned, and it did quite a thorough job and kept pet hair and dust at bay. I tested the D6 on sweeping up a few common spills, things like flour, cereal, cracker crumbs. The bot gets to things eventually and does sweep thoroughly when it goes over them, but if you've got a more concentrated spill to sweep, it does take a while. I tried using the Spot Clean setting found in the app's Options menu, but I didn't think it worked very well at all. The bot is supposed to do a small square area, according to Neato's website, but in my case, on test after test, it ignored the spot and went off at random. I do feel like the Neato D6, like the D7 I tested, got caught up in things more than a lot of other vacuums that I've dealt with. Things like power bars and bath mats were problematic, and it kept bottoming out on a chair with a half moon base. If it got into my husband's closet where there's clothes on the floor, the bot was a goner. Now, of course, you can remedy this by making places where your D6 tends to get stuck as no-go zones inside the app using the mapping, or doing as the Neato app suggests and picking up the messy floor first. Is the Neato D6 noisy? I'll say it up front, most robot vacuums are noisy. Is this one any more or less so than others? Not really. Well, I don't think most of us could sleep with a robot vacuum on and you'll want to take calls in another room, it's not deafening. I did feel, though, like the D6 sounded a little more rattly and clackety than the D7. It had a way of sounding clicky and like things were rattling around on it more so than I remember with the D7. Is there a difference in the way they're built? I can't say, but I did notice this noise. Overall, the Neato D6 does a good job, but it does have some downsides that mean it's not my favorite of the robot vacuums. The robot is thorough at cleaning, it does get into corners and edges really well, and the voice connectivity worked very well. I didn't feel like I was missing out on those extra features that are in the D7, so if budget's a concern for you, you could definitely save a few bucks. When it comes to the dislikes, the more rattly sound of this bot is definitely noticeable, and I actually had to stop and turn it over to see if there were some parts loose, though I couldn't find anything. I don't like the lack of dustbin full alerts. I do feel like this vacuum also got caught and stuck a bit more often than I'd like, and a bit more often than other robot vacuums I've tried. But you can work that out, of course, by creating those off-limits areas in your home and making sure that hazards like clothing are picked up. The Neato D6 sells for about $800 Canadian from places like Best Buy and Amazon. And if you'd like to read more about it, you can head over to techgadgetscanada.com where I've posted a full write-up. You can also ask me any questions you have about this device either there on the blog or, as always, here on the YouTube channel. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Erin. Until the next time, you can find me on Twitter or Instagram. I'm at ErinLYYC. You can also always catch me at facebook.com/techgadgetscanada.